And now the man who knows that no matter who the guest is, the show is always about him. The host of WinFunnel, Dino Bravo.
I am entertaining, and I know what viewers like you want. I've been behind the wheel of a race car, I've been underneath the race car turning the wrenches, I've been on both sides of this desk, I've been behind the camera, I've been in front of the camera, and I will bring 30 years of motorsports journalism to you in your living room. Welcome, race fans, to the Wind Funnel. I am your host, Dino Bravo. Great to have you along. We have once again taken the show on the road at the penultimate event. I love that word, penultimate. It means second to last. You know, like last would be the final, and the final would be the last. Penultimate means second to last. Anyway, we are at Turtle Creek Park for the penultimate event of the 2007-2008 HO Champ Car season. Let me bring you up to speed on some other HOCC news. Yours truly, Dino Bravo, has yet to receive a new contract to host the Wind Funnel. Current contract runs out at midnight on April 12th. HOCC TV management has yet to present me with an appropriate, acceptable contract. And without said solid offer, I will be unable to continue on as host of this show that I have made so very popular. Without further ado, let's bring in to the microphone here, Mark Walczak. Mark, good to see you. Great to have you on the Wind Funnel.
What's taking so long?
Well, it's the penultimate event. I like that word. I like you. I thought I'd bring you on the penultimate Wind Funnel.
Sounds
good. It's been an interesting year, to say the least.
What I have no clue. You tell me.
What?
You know what? I think that might be a little bit of the 3 mile mark warning horn you're hearing.
Oh, I see. A meltdown. Yes, you have a history of meltdowns, do you?
Last year. No, this year. Last couple events, kind of issues of my own creating.
I see. You and teammate Jim Iverson have worked so well together. Now it's been, what, 3 years?
Three and a half years
worked so well together, winning the Funt Cup for team points in runaway manner. But the two of you announced a couple weeks ago that PKVHO, as we know it, would be breaking up at the end of the season. Iverson will take the young phenom, Dean Strom, under his wing, mentor him much the same way that he has mentored you over the years.
When it came as a shock to me that he wanted to end it so early, you know. Luckily, I've got a press release from him saying that he will not race me in the heat race. We'll keep that going.
Uh-huh.
Let's go!
Who knows? While we're on top of sub sandwiches, first of all, you know how this works. I give you the quick answer, a quick question, you give me a quick answer.
All right.
Sub sandwiches, turkey or ham?
Turkey.
Cousins or Subway?
Cousins.
Oh man, we are right on this. Boxers or briefs?
Boxer briefs.
College hockey or pro hockey?
Ooh, I'd go pro hockey on that one.
Here's a seasonal one, Christmas or Easter?
Christmas.
80s rockers, Lita Ford or Pat Benatar?
None of the above.
All righty, and one last question. Choking the championship away or peeing the championship away?
None of the above. I'm still going to win this thing.
All right, Mark, great to have you aboard. Good luck the rest of the season. The penultimate event on HOCC TV.
Good evening, we are back. The HO Champ Car World Series is on to the next event. Another open class race here at the Turtle Creek Park. Another fast track and some fast cars. It's the penultimate event. I heard that word today, and that's an open wheel word. For you NASCAR folks,
that's a Formula One word.
It's next to last. That's what it means. There's one more to go after this. And we do have a point fight. We're not making this up. It's 2 points, Mark.
2 points between Mark Walczak and Jim Iverson. That's been dropping steadily the last four races. It's gone from 20 down to 2.
I heard Walczak's ahead in the popular vote. Iverson's trying to get the delegates for the banquet.
One mistake by either driver and their title shots may be over.
That's right. It could all end the night. It could be good for them, too. Who knows? It's the M&J Real Estate Investments. M&J. It's the Grand Prix here at the Turtle Creek Raceway Park Speedway.
The ultimate race.
One more to go after this. The big old 500, but we all know about that. Let's go racing here.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Family favorite show. Where everyone's my car pro. Where is it go?
this race called? M&J Peanut Butter Jelly, M&J March Madness, M&J Investments.
Good deal. That car number four, that car is really quick. That silver car there, that's Dan Marchetta. And that car there, that's Mark Walsh. Like, he's one of them guys who could win the whole championship, I think, right?
That's right. He's the point leader. He got fast laps. He's already got 1 point to his credit. This is another car that is fast tonight. That's Mike Fitzloff. He drives the same kind of car as Marchetta. Watch out for him. Very strong in practice. This is Jim Iverson. He's chasing Mark Walsh. He's right behind him on the starting grid. Think I ran into him?
I don't know, but you see that car there? That's Larry Ryder. I seen him qualify. He had no wheels. I don't know how he did it. I think he was, I don't know, it was magic car or something. But he still beat some guys. He beat that guy there. So that's Chris Spear. He's in sixth.
This guy won 2 weeks ago. It's Dean Strome. He won at the Walzak track. And alongside him is Mike Kristoff. He won this year, too.
And this guy didn't win yet. That's Tom Spear, the number two car. And this guy here, he's won twice. That's Oscar McCall. He won last week, right?
That's right. From the pole, from the outhouse, or the penthouse to the outhouse. He's going the wrong way. And that's Andy Spirit. He always qualifies back here.
But he's always in the outhouse.
I think he likes it there, though. That's just kind of stuff. This is the M&J March Madness here at the Turtle Creek Raceway Park. It's an open class race, and it's next. There's the big turtle. He's ready for some action.
M&J March Madness ready to roll off. This open class event should be exciting stuff. They come right at you here. Oh, a slow start there for Dean Strome, and into the trees for Ev Kamikawa already. And the early lead is Larry Rotter. He's got a full lap on the field already.
That's the one real tricky spot. As you see, Dan Marchetta have an off.
We're looking at the campsite that they allow here at Turtle Creek Park, right there along the creek, in between two of the longer straightaways. You know, little Chris Okonomaki, we've seen Ev Kamikawa crash into that campsite several times. I'd be afraid to pitch my tent there.
I know, I think they're stuck there. They can't get out because they got in there when the race started and they crossed the track and now they can't get back out, so they're running scared.
We did hear over his radio, he says that they do have good beer down in that campsite, so he might stop there a couple more times yet this race.
Could be. I think they have they've got the walleye and the sprecher in there, I guess, little Chris.
Yeah, but hopefully they're not dead, because when you're dead, you can't drink no sprecher beer.
Oh, that's a good point. Excellent point. One minute left to go here. The lead belongs to Larry Rotter, while Dean Strome and Dan Marchetta are battling each other for second place right now. Dan's trying to push. Oh, and then a big crash right there over the top of the bridge.
But Dean will be the one to watch the rest of this race as he's on that coveted transfer spot at this moment.
That's right. Second place driver with the most laps will advance to the final tonight. Larry Rotter, though, is safely into the final at his home track here at Turtle Creek. Here we go. It is the good start for Mike Fitzloff. Wow, did he get a jump there? Fitzloff, Jim Iverson, and Tom Spirit in this heat. And a full two straightaways now for Fitzloff. Iverson, of course, 2 points behind. Actually, he's now 3 points behind Mark Walzak for the Husarsbilt Championship. Iverson with a noisy car. That's kind of a rattle trap under there, little Chris Okonomaki.
I think you got to get the muffler checked.
Oh, the muffler, yeah. The muffler on those cars can be tricky sometimes. Of course, important for Iverson to make sure that he makes the final here in this tight points battle. Dan, Tommy, Kendall.
It's very important, and he's got something going for him that's here in the month of March. It's the luck of the Iverson. Hear the luck of the Irish? This is the luck of the Iverson. The guy qualifies not that great, middle of the pack, has a car that really didn't contend in practice and really wasn't setting the world on fire, but he's in the three-car heat, and he's leading right now over Mike Fitzloff, who has a faster car but can't keep it on the track. The luck of the Iverson is strong. Will it carry all the way to the HO Indy 500 as Iverson's going to get another lap right there. The speed beat luck. Here we go. Speed versus luck. The speed's out front right now, but don't count luck. Out. Yeah, luck is going south though right now. Oh, there he went off. He went off.
They have passed transfer spots.
They have both passed the transfer spots. They'll both continue. Dean Strome will sit. But this could be for the win. It's a precious points here for Iverson out front of Fitzloff. Here he comes. 16 seconds to go. The luck is winning. Here comes the speed. It's luck versus speed. Speed's out front. Iverson is in second. Oh, and he went off again. The luck wins every time. It always happens. Never bet against the luck. I'd rather be lucky than good any day, and Jim Iverson is just that. Lucky, he wins the race. 9:30. Heat race about to start. Andy Spirit, Mark Walczak, Chris Spirit, and Mike Kristoff. They are off. It's Walczak with the early lead. He goes streaking by. Walczak needs to win this. It's Walczak, Kristoff, and Spirit battling hard for second. We're going to give you a chance to meet some of the personalities of this series you don't get to see too much of. That black car right there, the black number 11, black car, that is Andy Spirit. And there he is. And, well, quite frankly, Andy doesn't get on TV too much. Dino Bravo, who's joining me in the booth. And, you know, we get Andy some airtime. What can we say about Andy Spirit?
Well, I saw him around the paddock area, and I didn't know what he was doing. Well, this explains it. Why? What do we say? He's a snappy dresser. Oh, you know what? He's the most eligible bachelor on the HOCC circuit.
Okay. All right. Guys in the truck are happy. We put Andy Spirit on camera. We're going to go back to the race now. That'll probably get cut in production anyway. Sorry, Andy. We tried. Oh! And that won't be on the cutting room floor right there. That was Mike Kristoff guaranteeing Andy Spirit will be on TV now because he just slammed into the bridge.
You know, a great story about racetracks is how they came to be and the history behind them. You know, the great history behind the Darlington Raceway, one thing, how the farmer had the fish pond and they wouldn't move the fish pond, so the track has got this strange shape. Well, this place has got a playground, and the school here, this little playground here, refused to leave. They said, nope, you build a racetrack around us. So that's what they did. These cars go whipping by these kids as they play right now. But, man, they're holding their ground. That's kind of neat to see, isn't it?
Yeah, that is kind of neat to see until one of them ends up dead because a car goes in there.
Mike Kristoff coming right at you there, right ahead of your leader, Mark Walczak. Who enjoys?
Just keep your camera on that Kristoff guy, and you're bound to get some good footage.
Every
crash footage, that is.
Oh, there it was. Oh, that went off. That car right there went off. That was huge implications. That wasn't Mike Kristoff.
Mark Walczak is still in the car and his car radio on.
Hey, guys, I'm over here by the sewer pipe. Can you guys come and get me out of the car for crying out loud? I mean, I win all these races for you. I'm good to you guys. I bought your Rolexes. Hey, the least you can do is get me out of this car.
They're telling me I got an interview, man. I know you're not the best time to do it, but...
Now what's the status of that?
What the heck happened?
Had a marshal in. You're fine, Dan. Had a marshal lean in, couldn't see over the bridge, and up and over I went. Just gave my teammate his second title. Congratulations to him. First time since Ev went back-to-back in 2000-2001.
Hey, there's one more race going on, and you got the fastest cars in the circuit.
I may have the fastest cars in the circuit, but you figure I finished dead last. He's going to be...
Luck of the Irish.
There you go. It'll give him 30 plus points up on me going into the final race. I've got no shot. It's over.
But this guy, Chris Spirit, right there, winner of the season opener way, way back in September, is on his way to a heat win victory and a berth in the M&J March Madness. He's on his lid and hitting. The car is not sounding very, there's something very wrong with the car. The race is over. He won the race upside down on his lid. There is something definitely wrong. The car needs to be fixed. He broke something on the car. A wild third heat race here at Turtle Creek.
Here's Jim Iverson, the professor, the Gray Fox. Jim, some stunning things happened tonight.
Stunning. I'm just amazed. I don't know how I'm going to do in this race. I'm just stunned.
To quote you, you said, I've got to get a beer. Now, not to crown you the heir apparent and to congratulate you prematurely, after all, but honestly, what are your reactions to potentially winning your second championship?
Oh, it'd be very, very sweet. I would really love to win it. I didn't think it was possible. This has been a mediocre year. Mark was running away with his race. No one was pushing him. I can't believe it happened. And ending up in last place, it's a worst-case scenario. The worst-case scenario for him.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. We did not want to see the title race come down to something like that. I think all the fans would admit that they wanted something head-to-head on the track. But tonight's race, you've got a final race. Now, you've got luck and a good handling car. Fitzloff says he has speed, Rodder has track knowledge. Chris Spirit is hoping some of his luck from you will spill over onto him. What secret weapon do you have?
Where did this luck nonsense come from? I've got more death cards than anybody. I just, you know, try hard, keep my head down. I'm consistent. You make your own luck in this league.
And we're walking through the paddock sill. You turn to the left, you turn to the right. You can't swing a dead cat without hitting drivers here. And we came across the other finalist here. This is Mike Fitzloff. Now, Mike, you absolutely, for over the years that you've been racing in Champ Car, you have absolutely some of the fastest cars ever. Tonight, you've got one of those fast cars.
I hope it lasts, though. It's quick, but I don't have the handling that Iverson has, so I got to stay with him.
So Iverson's got the luck in the handling. Chris Spirit is hoping for some luck. Rada has track knowledge. What is your strength?
All right, the start of the final M&J March Madness, and a slow start for Chris Spirit. We're worried about the mechanics on that car. In the meantime, the lead now between Larry Rotter and Mike Fitzloff. They are side by side to start this thing off. And Everett Bell, this looks like it could be quite a duel.
That's right. Oh, so I was just running up from the paddock here. Yeah, absolutely, it could be a duel tonight. I think, you know, one of the things that Chris Spirit, we saw his car start slowly. We saw his car with problems in his heat race. I think that's one of his strategic advantages. He's hoping his car breaks. The other cars run over part of his car. They blow a tire. They go off the track. And then he just continues on his merry way, hopefully without a black flag.
It's a devilish plan. Maybe it'll work. In the meantime, first and second place, fiendish indeed. First and second here, right in front. Larry Rotter, oh, and a spin for Fitzloff. That's going to put Larry, hometown favorite Larry Rotter, out front. We're heading into baseball season here as March Madness winds down. Look who's here in the booth.
Holy cow, it's good to be at this park of Perk Eternal. And I have to say, holy cow! Larry Rotter's got problems with his car. I have no idea. Look at, I think that's Mark Sandberg in the pits. Steve, we need another beer. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks, Harry.
Traffic
here. You see, first and second side by side. Fitzloff, Iverson. Right behind Fitzloff Rotter, then Iverson right behind. Closing in, look at this. They're going to be three wide for the lead as we come to the end of the first half. Mike Fitzloff hung right up on the fence. He's in for a stop-and-go penalty, Howard Cosell.
Absolutely. Mike Fitzloff wants this victory. He might be over-revving the car and overcharging. There he is, right there, as he drives along through this lane.
Larry had to find his wheel. Dan, Tommy, Kendall, that car went deep into the, it rolled all the way down here by the creek.
That's right. When the debris field goes all the way across the racetrack, it's a huge hit, and it was for Rada. The front wheel came off. He had a problem in practice, but it came off again. The car is missing a wheel. That's not the car that is missing the wheel. It's coming right here. He's running around without a wheel. The front wheel is off. The front wheels are off the Rotter car. What is going on here? There's no wheels on the Rotter car. Mike Fitzloff is in trouble. It's the luck of the Iverson. It's coming back. He's going to get back into this.
As I was saying, there's Larry Rotter's reel. His wheel is right there.
Steve, give this man some wheels. I think you can fashion him out of some bud cans. That's Larry. He's a bud man. He's a no front wheels man.
He's been driving on two wheels. He's due into the pits to put back two wheels back on the car. He's popping that. They're popping that body off. Crew quickly going to work, throwing that front axle back on to the chassis. That Butler Rotter Racing following that pit stop. Larry Rotter is running in second place. He's about eight laps down to Mike Fitzloff. Now, let's review some history here, ladies and gentlemen. It was this very race where Mike Fitzloff was looking like it was going to be his victory one year ago. And then something horrible went wrong.
Around Amy.
Front.
Nice and smooth. Oh, Mike's off! Mike's off! Fitzloff with a DNF! Butler just needs to stay smooth for the next 40 seconds, and she's got her second consecutive win.
Could be setting up to have a similar situation with Butler's teammate.
Whoa, there was a hard hit for Rotter. Are all the tires still on that car? Or did that front axle come off this time again? Man, that was... Chris Spirit continues to struggle. We saw at the end of his heat race, the car absolutely would not go more than a couple hundred feet at a time without it coming apart, and he's working on it again.
And the open-wheel cars are really putting on quite a show. For if you like action, if you like cars flying over the place, like a lot of our fans here.
I guess so.
Larry Rotter won the first three races run in HO Champ Car here at Turtle Creek. And then we saw Mark Walczak break that streak, Amy Butler a year ago, and now it looks like with 15 seconds left to go, Mike Fitzloff is going to get his second win of the season and his first here at Turtle Creek Park in the final open class race of the season. And Fitzloff wins a brutal M&J March Madness, and madness it was indeed.
Down here in a crazy victory lane here at Turtle Creek Park. On a night we saw all kinds of things happen. The talk was the luck of the Iverson, but it's the fortunes of the Fitzloff that comes through with the win. Mike Fitzloff, your second win this season.
Yeah, it was great. RJ put one heck of a car together. Hey, okay, RJ, calm down. Thanks, Daniel. Right.
Your track owner here, Larry Rotter, is going to present you with, looks like you're getting a house.
Hey,
corkscrew.
I'll take that. Yeah, my wife likes her wine. She'll build it up.
Mike. HO Indy 500 is next, and you're really fighting with Dean Strom for that fifth spot.
Yeah, we actually want to get like top three, so we're hoping we got one heck of a car for Indy put aside already, and we're hoping to win Indy. We need one. We need it.
All right, he's looking to win Indy. That's Mike Fitzloff. He's your winner tonight. There's one race left to go. It's the HO Indy 500. It's the one everybody wants. It's for all the marbles. It's coming up in 2 weeks' time. There was a championship fight until this race happened, but don't count Mark Walczak off.
It's not over.
Remember, Iverson failed to qualify for that race last year, told Walczak bail him out with a car. That won't happen this year. So anything can happen. It's in 2 weeks' time. And it'll be our final race of the season. Probably the greatest season we ever had. 10 winners, will there be an 11th? That means you, Amy Butler. That means you, Tom Spirit. That means you, Andy Spirit. You got to step up in 2 weeks. We'll see you then.